Hey, what's up everybody? Faye here. Welcome back to a new video. Today, I will be going through episode 8 of our Pokémon Let's Go Pikachu series. So, let's get right into it. Off camera, I did a couple things. One, I did some research on whether or not you can get like the old rod and all the fishing rods in Pokémon Let's Go. And turns out you can't. The only way to access the water only Pokemon is to wait until you get the secret technique for Swift Swim, and it's basically just the secret technique replacement for Surf. But yeah, until then I can't really access the water or the Pokemon that go in the water. But the other thing that we did in between episodes is this. I actually ended up needing to borrow my parents' system, so they ended up letting me borrow their system. I had a Pokemon Let's Go Eevee copy. I had to take a minute to get through the game on their copy, on their Switch, but once I was able to trade, I was able to actually trade evolve my Kadabra into an Alakazam. If you don't remember, in the last episode, I ended up spending a good minute trying to catch an Abra. I caught one, got it evolved into a Kadabra right before the episode ended, and I got it evolved in between episodes, and now we got a fully evolved Alakazam. Turns out it's a timid nature, which, what does that mean for it? What does that mean? I think that's actually a good nature right there. I think it boosts speed. The speed gets boosted and the physical attack gets lowered. I'm pretty sure psychic type moves are all physical moves. So I think a better stat boost would have been to boost special attack over speed, but it's okay, because after my Alakazam evolved, it learned Calm Mind, which focuses its mind and calms its spirits to rank. It raises basically the Pokemon's special attack and special defense stats, so this guy's gonna be a decent Pokemon. I just gotta teach him some better moves, which, since he's only level 16 and he'll be on the team for a while, he'll be gaining some good XP and over time learning some more moves. And because he was a trade Pokemon, because I had to trade him to evolve him, I actually ended up it's gonna end up getting boosted XP for trading, so I'll be able to get it leveled up a lot faster. Okay, so in this episode, I want to try to be able to at least get the stuff done to be able to do the third gym. So I'm just gonna have to go through the S.S. Anne and do all that stuff in this episode. Okay. Cool. I'm also currently recording this episode at nearly 3 in the morning. Oh, there you are, Fate. Thanks again for the ticket. This ship is huge, and it's full of trainers. Bonjour, if it isn't Fate and Nathan. Didn't think I'd be seeing the two of you here. Hey, Blue. Are you taking a cruise? Not hardly. I got invited to the exclusive party for trainers, where I'm pretty much done with the scene. I got plenty of party favors too. Here, I can even share one with you. Got the Chalure Stable from Sable from Blue. More importantly though, you want to know what I overheard at the party? You guys know about Team Rocket, right? I battled them before. Seriously? You must be fearless or something, kid. Anyway, the point is this. Team Rocket is a dangerous group, and they're trying to use Pokemon to make themselves rich. shouldn't you already know about this? Didn't you have to deal with them in the past? Whatever. I might do some digging into what it is they're really after. And you two better stay out of their path. See you, man. Whatever, man. Well, as I was saying, I'm recording this video at nearly 3 in the morning. So what I'm trying to prove by that is, kind of proves my amount of dedication to the channel and to you guys that I care. Because I didn't have a video ready for this for tomorrow, for today. So I kind of just wanted to stay awake and record a video real quick so I can get a video ready. I'm also getting some stuff behind the scenes good. Maybe for one of the things I'm getting is potentially for a new video series, so that'll be cool. But anyways, hey Faye, over here. What's up, Nathan? You see those stairs there? The captain's quarters are up there. He can teach you this cool secret technique if you ask him. He's really famous for it. Though he looked pretty done in by seasickness when I saw him. Hey, before you go to meet him, how about I take a look to see how well you've been raising your Pokemon, huh? Sure. I accept your challenge, I guess? Alright, Nathan. Pidgeotto? Pretty sure I'm leading with Pikachu, so... What level is Pidgeotto? 20. Okay, so I'm not, like, under level. You zippy zap. I was kind of worried in the last episode that I was under level. Okay, perfect. Love that move, by the way. Zippy zap is insane. Charmeleon gained a level. Eevee. Let's just keep Pikachu going. Eevee's level 21, so it's like approaching my Pokemon level. Bite. Okay, I'm gonna just use Double Kick again to guarantee that day. Or he'll Super Poke. What a little bitch. Over here healing the second it gets tough for him. Come on, man. I mean, I know I Oko'd your last Pokemon, but do you really have to be that much of a bitch? Okay, let's just use Double Kick to guarantee the kill now. Now that his Eevee's down. Pikachu level 24, hell yeah. That's what I love to see. Slam? I do not trust that move. Even if I have useless moves right now, I would rather keep the useless move than learn that move. I think Alakazam would be super effective, but Alakazam is also slightly underleveled for everything for right now. Going against an Oddish, I'm pretty sure Psychic is super effective against Poison, but 4 levels lower, even though Charmeleon is 3 levels lower. Sleep Powder, that's gonna be a pain in the ass. If only we got the Burn Off. We got the burn off from the Ember, that would have been perfect. I don't think Charmeleon has Flame Body either. So it's not like we could just get it to inflict damage on us and then fucking destroy it. Oh damn. Well, if Charmeleon stays knocked out for another turn, we might be fucked. And we're fucked. If he uses acid again, which it is, that should be Charmeleon going down. Oh no, it's not. I'm switching. Okay. Who to switch to though? It's a grass and poison type. I could throw Alakazam out there, but he's 4 levels lower. No. Why did I send Charmeleon in there? I can just send Pidgeotto in there. Pidgeotto's a level higher than him. What the fuck am I doing? I don't know why I sent Charmeleon out there in the first place. Now he's at 2 HP and asleep, so I gotta get up the Pokemon Center as soon as I get to the Pokemon Center. Well, actually, I don't think I do any battles after this one. I mean, I think the rest of them are optional. Even then, I don't think I'll be able to do them. Because as soon as I get done with this place, if I go to the Pokemon Center, then this boat's gonna end up leaving. Wow, Fate, you've gotten pretty strong. Nothing. That's cool. Anyway, go meet the captain and have him show you his secret technique.
Okay.
I'll go do that. Hey, buddy. Oh, I feel terrible.
Burp.
This seasickness has done me in. You rub the captain's back. There, old fellow. Woo, thank you. Feeling much better now. So what did you want from me? Oh, you want to learn my secret technique? Of course I'd be happy to teach it. Come along with me.
Pika Pika!
Ha ha ha. That Pikachu looks more than ready to learn my secret technique, but I'm afraid it's really only for humans. What's this? You really want to try to learn it? No matter what? Well, color me surprised. I've traveled all over this wide world, and this is the first time I've had a Pokemon want to learn my secret technique. But with spirit like that, well then, who am I to say no? I'll teach my special technique, my special secret technique, even to that Pikachu of yours. Come with me, little friend. Now watch carefully. Hiya, da! Pikachu learned the secret technique Chop Down. So it's basically just a replacement for Cut. Whoa ho! You really went and learned Chop Down. Using Chop Down, your Pikachu will be able to help you chop down thin trees. You could go give it a try. That's right. How about on the trees around Vermilion City? Woo! I guess it's about time for the S.S. Anne to set sail again. This may be goodbye for now, until the next time we return to Vermilion City. Yeah, if that even ever happens. It does kind of suck that I'm having to leave this place behind, because there's a bunch of good optional battles I could use for XP, and I won't be able to use those, because this place is about to set sail once I step out of the ship. And especially since I feel like I'm a little bit under-leveled for the next gym. Never mind. What's up with you, big man? Okay. Are there any other trees I can just chop down and check out? Rather than this one? I guess I'm gonna have to. Yo, champ in the making! Beyond this point, it's a Vermilion City gym. But you'll need to chop that tree down first. But I think you and Pikachu will have no trouble slicing through. Come on, give it a shot. Okay. Yes. Boom. Good work. You chopped down that troublesome tree and opened a way to the gym. And that means you can challenge the gym now. I'll be waiting for you there. Before I do that, though, I think I gotta heal. Then I also will need to catch myself a Diglett up in Diglett Cave. One for the Pokedex, two to help out in this gym. Just saying. Yeah, because, I mean, Pidgeotto could help with ground, with electric. No, he can't. No, this next one up is electric. no one on my team could really do anything. I mean, Pikachu and Ivysaur both resisted. And Charmeleon's neutral to it. That's about it. None of them can really do any good damage back. I mean, Ivysaur's typing is also resisted by electric types. So it's kind of like a resist-resist relationship between them. Maybe a Diglett isn't the only option. You know what, let's go catch a Diglett first. Before I try to... Because I do still need a Mr. Mime from that area. But before I do that, let's get myself a good old casting Diglett. What's up with this guy? This path is closed because Diglett dug too many holes. While we're filling the holes, why don't you challenge the Vermilion City Gym? Am I required to go through Diglett Cave? Okay, you'll be my Diglett. What level are you? 14 is a bit. Let me switch to, first Pokemon throw of the game of the episode so far, and it's a good old break throw. Okay, another break throw. Two break throws in a row, back to back, see what happens. Damn. And another break throw. 3 for 3 on the break throw. But he's breaking out of all of them, so it really doesn't. Excellent throw. Perfect. 3 great throws to stack up to an excellent throw. Damn, it still broke out. I don't know what the fuck I'm gonna do. And boom. Another great throw. I'll take it. If it works. There. Finally, we got that Diglett. We can add it to the team. We should probably... should we train it up, or should I? I mean, it's a new Pokedex entry, so... What other ground types are in the game? There's the Nidoking line, Nidoqueen line... Let's get out of this cave. Nidoking, Nidoqueen, Diglett line... I can't really think of any others. There's probably more. Oh, Rhydon, Geodude line... I want to get a Rhydon on the team. I feel like that would be good. Okay, so I'm gonna put. Wait, what? Squirtle's one level away from evolving. But this next gym is an electric gym. So, speaking of which, I'm probably gonna take Pidgeotto off of the team for the sake of. Grinding up Diglett. As soon as this gym is done, though, we're taking Diglett off the team. What moveset do you have? You don't even have a ground type move? Are you kidding me? Well, to be fair, you also do have a. You have. I have a TM for Dig in my bag. I need to use it. I mean, catching a ground type Pokemon is useful, but not if it can't learn a single fucking ground type. I mean, it's gonna be complete bullshit if I caught it just for it to not be useful. Because what else am I gonna use? The only weakness that Electric has is fucking ground. Use Zippy Zap on this guy. Sorry about that background noise if you guys hear it. It's actually my fan in my room. I don't know what's wrong with it, but it just keeps making that annoying ass noise constantly. Mr. Mime, I want you. I want to add you to the collection with the rest of my Pokemon. Mr. Mime. Hell yeah. first try, excellent throw. I don't know if you guys saw the last episode, but I struggled catching a Mr. Mime. So catching a first try this time is actually feeling great. Charmeleon, level 18. Alakazam, level 17. Rattata, level 19. Rattata is one level away from evolving. Mr. Mime is added to the collection. Pokedex first. Cool. Psychic and Fairy. That's a decent typing, but I prefer just good old Alakazam. I already got an Alakazam on the team. I think it gained boosted XP. I haven't seen it gain any boosted XP so far, but I've seen anything said about it getting any boosted XP, but whatever. Poliwag? Oh, hell yeah. Okay, I'll just use Thunderbolt on this thing. Yeah, level 18. Thunderbolt. Throwing. Hell yeah. What I like to see. Get fucked. That shot. And I have to go to that descent. Thunderbolt again. I don't even know, like, what the typing thing. Like, I don't know if fighting is... I think fighting an electric is the same situation as fire an electric. Really? Diglett, you learned Fury Slash. I've never heard a growl for it, but like... Dude, you're a level 15 Diglett that knows no ground type moves, despite being a ground type. Pretty sure you're a pure ground type. Pretty sure he is. Whatever. Hopefully the rest of these trainers can help you out. I might have to do some catch training off camera or something if I end up not being able to finish this off. I'll just make this episode purely about like finding levels for the rest of it and then having it as like an S.S. Anne based episode or something. It's just a disaster. Boom. Damn, that was a critical hit as well. Light screen. Maybe keeping Voltorb out there wasn't the best idea. Then again, I have no good Pokemon for electric types. That's kind of why I'm doing it. Swift doesn't miss. I only get 6 XP. Well, 6 HP. Let's just hit it with a Thunderbolt again to guarantee the kill. Beat this guy? Guess so. I know there's a few trainers I haven't beat yet, so where are they? This guy. Have I challenged you yet? No, I haven't. I am now. Perfect. You've never won before? Well, let's not let that happen now, then. You only have one Pokemon, that's why. A Vulpix. Vulpix and Growlithe are like version exclusives from each other. And considering I got a Growlithe on here, I'm assuming I can't get a Vulpix unless I trade it over from Let's Go Eevee. But speaking of which, I might want to go ahead and catch like another Pidgey or something. Maybe not a Pidgey, but I might want to go catch a another Oddish. Because Oddish is the version exclusive for Let's Go Pikachu. But Bellsprout is the Pokemon for the version exclusive on Let's Go Eevee. At least for like the beginning grass type Pokemon you can catch. So if I trade an Oddish from my game on Let's Go Pikachu for a Bellsprout on the Let's Go Eevee game on my family's account, then I can actually get a version exclusive Pokemon accessible, fully evolve it, and then have all the members of it in the Pokedex. 3 Pokedex entries that I usually couldn't get a fully obtained. That would be great. Level 18, the exact same level as Charmeleon. Charmeleon's got this. Chameleon is technically super effective against it if it uses Ember, since it's part Steel type. Why are you spamming Supersonic, dog? That's so fucking annoying. Something I have noticed in this game is that catching Pokemon does actually, like, surprisingly, catching Pokemon, I think, gives more SP than battling trainers. Which is weird, because I thought it would be the other way around. Pikachu level 25, nice. Ivysaur level 20, I'd like to see it. Voltorb. Is Voltorb also part Steel type, or is it part of, is it just pure electric? I guess we can keep Charmeleon out there and find out. If it says super effective on Ember, then we know it's part Steel type. If it just doesn't say anything, that means it's neutral, and it's just pure electric. Okay, thank you. Okay, it's neutral and it's pure electric. Good to know. I guess I'll keep Charmeleon out there, have to fight off the confusion, and have to get outsped the whole time. Don't let it go. Good. Hopefully in the next turn, I'll snap out. Just don't die in this turn, don't get fucked up by confusion, or get fucked up by paralysis. Do not get fucked up by either one. Good. Fought through both paralysis and confusion at the same time to take us to victory. Love to see it, Charmeleon. I'll go heal you in a bit. Let's finish off these trainers. I don't think you should be needed in the rest of these battles. But if you're needed, then I'll probably heal you mid-battle. Okay, that guy's not even a battling trainer. Okay, this guy's next. He looks like the type of guy to own water types. He's a sailor, so I'd assume. A Slowpoke, okay. I forgot Slowpoke was a Gen 1 Pokemon. Damn, okay. Let's just hit it with a Thunderbolt. Super effective to stab Thunderbolt. Thunderbolt is 90 power, right? I think it is. 90 power, 100 accuracy. I think it's a special move. Yeah. The more trainers I beat here, and the more money I get, the more items I get, the better. Oh, speaking of items, it's over here. 5 Great Balls, I'll take it. I would go try to deal with that tiny Mr. Mime, but I don't think I'll be able to. Is this girl just going to block me from going over there, or is she going to battle me? Okay, good. She's going to battle me. I prefer that than just a bitch that's just going to stand here and block me from going in there. Jigglypuff. I think Double Kick should be perfect on this one. Yeah, especially since I'm 9 levels high. Okay, Pikachu, you got this with Double Kick. Boom. I got a Quick Attack for the next turn. Perfect. Love the fact that you dodged it. Quick Attack for the win. Right? Boom. Okay. That's what I love to see. Nidorino. Oh, fuck it. Let's try it. Let's try Alakazam out for the first time. Trying Alakazam out for the very first time in battle. Didn't try Abra out because it was level 15, but it also did not be attacking. It learned Psybeam when it evolved into a Kadabra, but I got it. I managed to get it into the evolve after. Oh, hell yeah. And, Alakazam's getting a level 15. Oh, he doesn't get boost XP? They don't get boosted XP for trading stuff in this game? That sucks. I guess I want to keep your Pokemon level with the rest of them. That sucks. Go heal, I guess. We do have the TM for Dig that we can just go ahead and teach to Dig with. We'll Dig with. I think Raticate. If I can get Raticate evolved real quick, I could actually have him learn Dig. Not even need Dig with. Switch out my Pidgeotto for that. Let's go, team. I'm not asking you. Okay, heal time. Okay, so Pikachu can learn it, Charmeleon can learn it, Diglett can learn it, and Alakazam can learn it. I'm just gonna teach it to, for now, just Diglett. Let's get rid of Agility. Agility raises the speed stat, and Sand Attack lowers the opponent's accuracy. I think I'd rather have Sand Attack than Agility, at least for this Diglett. Sand Attack's cool for a gimmick, and also because it'll actually be useful to get rid of the fucking opponent's accuracy to make it harder to hit. Diglett's only level 15, but let me send him into the front. I'm also going to end off the video here. I know it's a little bit early, but the video's gone on for long enough, and I want to save the next gym for the next episode. I've already gone on for long enough before the episode can end, so I'm going to end it right here. If you like what you saw, please leave a like on the video. Comment down below saying you enjoyed the video, as well as if you want a Pokemon in my collection to be either named after you or after a suggestion you have, just leave a comment down below with the comment saying that you enjoyed the video. Saying what Pokemon you want out of my collection to be nicknamed, along with if you want it to be named after you or after a suggestion you have. Subscribe to this channel, hit the notification bell so you don't miss an upload. Subscribe to my music channel called Fate Knox. Hit the notification bell over there so you don't miss a music upload. If you want an alternative way to listen to my music other than YouTube, my SoundCloud is a good way to listen to it. That account is called Fate Knox. I only have one album called Goated on there right now, but if you want an alternative way to listen to that other than YouTube, SoundCloud is a great way to do so. Follow my Instagram, Fate_Knox. Follow my Twitter, Fate_Knox_. That's right, I checked my Twitter earlier today and know what the ad is now. Follow my TikTok called Fate Knox. I've been getting a lot more active on TikTok since coming back to YouTube, so giving that account a follow as well and maybe watching a video or two while you're over there is appreciated. So with all that being said, my name is Fate, here with episode 8 of Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye guys.